to get 2010. Question number 2, page number 103, ME 2010. 2 marks question. Precedence and activity relation he has given. Activity precedence and duration. Duration in days. PQRSTUVW. These are the activities. The precedence activity for P is nothing, Q is nothing, for R it is P, for Q it is S, for T it is R, S, for U it is R, S, for V it is T, for W it is U. 3, 4, 5, 7, 5, 2, 10. These are the durations of the activity. First, draw the network diagram. Starting 2 activities. P, Q. And next. Q is R is after P. R is after P. Okay, so R is after P. Next, S is after Q. S is after Q. T is after R and S. And U is after R and S. Next, V is after T. W is after U. So this is a diagram. He has given durations P 3, Q 4, R 5, S 5, T 7, U 5, V 2, W 10. Critical path. By the end of this, here it is 3. If it comes here, 4. 3 plus 5, 8. 4 plus 5, 9. So maximum 1 is 9. We have to take maximum 1. So till here, what is critical path? This is a critical path. And from this side, 9 plus 7, 16. 16 plus 2, 18. 9 plus 5, 14. 14 plus 10, 24. So the critical path is Q, S, U, W is critical path. Project duration is 24 days. QSUW. That's a question. Answer is D. Next, question number 5. The expected time of a PERT and activity in terms of optimistic, pessimistic and most likely time. So expected time equal to T optimistic plus 4 most likely plus T pessimistic by 6. So answer is A, Next question. He has given the network and he is asking critical path of the duration. Linked answer question. Before solving this, we do some other problem which is need to be completed. 23, question number 23, page number 107, gate 2005. A project has 6 activities A to F with respect to the activity duration 7 5 6 6 8 4. These are the activities and activity durations. Network has 3 paths A, B, C, D, E, F. All 3 activities can be crashed with the same cost per day. Crash cost per day. The number of activities need to be crashed to reduce the project duration by 1 day. So crash critical paths are A, B, C, D, E, F. A, B sum is 12, B, C, A, B, C, D sum is 12, E, F sum is 12. So all the paths, the duration is coming as 12. So all these 3 acts as a critical paths. So if you want to reduce the project duration by 1 day, then you need to reduce 3 days. Because if you reduce one day any of the path, that path will duration reduces. Then, so because that means project duration, if you want to reduce project duration, you need to reduce in all paths. Then only you can reduce project duration. Otherwise, project duration will be constant if you reduce in single path. The 3 activities has to be crashed. To reduce 1 day. Question number 8 and 9, linked answer question. Diagram he has given. This is a diagram. He has mentioned optimistic and pessimistic time of each activity. So from that activity 1 to 2. So I will write expected times calculation after by using optimistic and pessimistic time. T expected equal to T optimistic plus 4 T most likely plus pessimistic by 6. After applying that formula on each and every activity, the values of T expected is 1 to 2, 2, 1 to 3, 6, 1 to 4. One to four is 5, 2 to 5 is 7, 3 to 5 is 4, 5 to 6 is 5, 4 to 7 is 6, 6 to 7 is 3. So substituting 1 to 2, 2, 1 to 3, 6, 1 to 4, 5, 2 to 5, 7, 3 to 5, 4, 5 to 6, 5, 4 to 7, 6, 6 to 7, 3. So, for calculating the critical path, find the prior completion time. 6. So, here it is 6. It is 2. It is 5. So, these two activities are coming and merging. 6 plus 4 plus 4, 10. 7 plus 2, 9. Whichever is maximum, 10. 10 plus 5, 15. 5 plus 6, 11. 15 plus 3, 18. Whichever is maximum. Whenever there are two activities are merging, whichever is maximum, we will take the maximum value. So 18 days is the prior duration. First question, 8th question. The critical path duration of the network is, the critical path is, what is critical path? 18. So this way it will go, 6 plus 4, 10. Critical path is 1, 3, 5, 6, 7. Critical path duration is 18 days. Standard deviation of critical path. Again, standard deviation is nothing but variance, square root of variance, square of variance. Standard deviation sigma equal to square of variance. Square root of variance. So variance for each path you need to calculate. So 1 to 2. Variance is nothing but, what is the variance formula? Tp minus Tpo by 6 whole square. So substituting this value here and simplifying, total variance equal to sum of the variances, I equal to 1 to n activities, Tp minus To by 6 of those particular activities, all activities. Standard deviation is square root of variance. So answer is, it is the 9th question, variance is asking. So answer for 9th question is 0.88 is near about 77. C is answer. Is asking standard deviation is nothing but square root of variance. So similar question, ring critical path is given P and Q are the P, Q or S. So G. Sorry. These are the points given. For the network below, the objective is to find the long of the shortest path. So find the length of the shortest path from the node P to G. Let Dij be path of P to G. Dij equal to what is that? Be the length of the direction directed, length of directed from node I to J. Here Sj is nothing but satisfies which of the following. Sj is shortest path from P to J and Sg is the shortest path from P to Sg is the shortest path from P to G. If you want to get the from P point to the G point, end point, so you need to know, you check the cross verify, check the options. First option A is Sg equal to minimum of SQSR. SQ is nothing but distance from P to Q and R to Q. It is not the right. It is not the one we need. We need distance from P to G. So Sg equal to again SQ minus DQG. If you subtract it, it is not. SQ is equal to minimum of SQ plus DQG. If you add, then only it will satisfy. So C is the option which satisfies the question, I mean answer of, for the question. So this is about PERT and CPM. So we have seen so many CPM PERT problems and network, especially actually these are used for the majorly networking critical path methods. There is another question 27. PERT analysis is critical activity has zero float. Remember, critical activity has zero float.